Hi, welcome to Magpie's Goodnight Stories. Tonight, I'm going to read you a story about a very precious creature. Giraffe Problems, written by Jory John, illustrated by Lane Smith. Giraffe Problems. Wonder what kind of problems could a giraffe could have? What kind of problems might a giraffe encounter on its journey across a savanna? Well, I can tell the creators of this book, the illustrator, had a problem. Where is the head and the horns of that giraffe? Well, right here. They found a solution to fit the giraffe, but I can already tell where the problem lies. Well, beautiful pattern we are familiar with. And brown and yellow. And look at giraffe problems. I feel bad about my neck. I do. I can't help it. Why would it feel bad? It's too long, too bandy, too narrow, too dopey, which is kind of foolish looking, that's what it means. Too patterned. Could that be a problem too? I love that pattern. Too stretchy, too high, too lofty, which is what you say about a person that looks at you from up high. Too necky? I don't really know how to explain that word to you. Yes, my neck is too necky. Everybody stares at it. Have you got something in you that you feel that everyone stares at? I do. I'm gonna keep it a secret. Well, this guy, that guy, him, her, them, whatever that is, and her again, all staring, which is looking and looking and not stopping. Well, we've got a problem. They found a solution. The giraffe's neck across two pages. Yep, I feel bad about my neck. What has the giraffe tried to do to solve that problem? Yeah, you're right. Covering up. I've tried dressing it up. I've added a scarf, two scarves, a bundle of scarves. I've tried bow ties. And regular ties. And both. Well, that would be everything then. Well, obviously that didn't work because the giraffe keeps trying. What else can a giraffe cover up its neck with? Well, take a look. I've tried hiding it away. I've used shrubs, even on its horns. I've hung out in ditches, in the fields, goodness me. I've stood behind trees. Look at that tall palm tree. And something hiding in the leaves. I've spent time in the river, just casually hanging out. Other animals have necks that just work. Take a gander at the zebra's neck, which is, take a quick look. Stripes always look good, so classic. Quit staring at me. Or gaze upon this elephant's neck, which is, take a closer look at it, study it out. Strong and powerful, yet graceful. Stop talking about me. Or glimpse this lion, whose neck is adorned with a glorious mane of flowing locks. What a sight, how inspiring. Why can't I have a neck like that? Are you always this loud? Said Mr. Lion. My mom always said I should be proud of my neck. She said other animals would love to have a neck like this. Yeah, right. No offense, Mom. But nobody wants this neck. It's a neck only a mother could love. It all makes me want to hide until the sun sets. Well, shush! Hiding until the sun sets. Good evening, says the rock. Look at that rock, that pebble. The giraffe stumbled upon a speaking, talking rock. I've been admiring your neck from afar. Oh, how I wish my neck looked like yours. I'd get so much done in a day. Goodness, I can only imagine all the reaching and grabbing and looking around I'd do. I'd accomplish many of my goals, for sure. Meanwhile, I'm saddled with this little excuse for a neck. Here, watch me try to stretch it out. See? That's about as far as it goes. Pathetic, right? I'm basically neckless. So, you feel bad about your neck too? Yep. I'm Cyrus, by the way. I'm Edward. It's lovely to meet you, Cyrus. Goodness me, two completely different necks, and they both feel about bad about themselves. Can I tell you something else, Edward? Of course, Cyrus. You think that's going to be something nice? Well, there is a story. The giraffe is just going to find out. It's written in this way. Could it be because Mr. Cyrus could only look from left to right and not from top to bottom easily? There is a hill in a distance which you can surely see from your great vantage. I've stood on that very hill for 7 straight days now, staring skyward, which is in the direction of the sky, watching as a single piece of fruit, a lone banana, slowly changed from green to, you're right, to yellow, ripening. I've endured windy nights and unseasonably brisk mornings with very little sleep as I waited and waited, hoping against hope that the fruit would drop before me so I could sample its sweetness and nourish myself in the process. Yet day after day, I felt like such a fool as I stretched my neck towards those greedy branches, only to be limited by my own physical shortcomings. You want a banana from a tree? That's what I said, yes. Well, look at that. Plunk! Plunk, plunk. Just one plunk. That was an echo in the tent. Here you go. What? Oh, you did it. You made it look so easy. Munch, 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 delectable. So that's what a banana tastes like, huh? It was worth the wait. Somebody made somebody else super happy and it was very easy. Edward, face it, your neck is impressive. It allows you to do amazing things. For instance, you just solved my week-long banana dilemma in 10 seconds. Well, thank you, Cyrus. I think you have a swell neck, too. It's elegant and dignified, and it works well with your shell. That means a great deal to me, Edward. So, do you like bow ties, Cyrus? I'm not sure, Edward. I have very little experience with them. You look wonderful, Cyrus. As do you, Edward. Look at them, so happy together with the necks that they just hated so much, huh? I feel good about our necks, Edward. Thank you, Cyrus, for once. So do I. Yes, for once, so do I. What a happy story after all. What seemed to be a problem for a giraffe turned out to be an advantage to somebody else, and they just made a great, great friendship. Good night. Sleep tight. See you at magpie again.